LeBron James all the way in.
Here comes Simmons the other way. 3-on-2. Simmons eludes the defender and lays it in with that. Certainly the length altered that shot. Out of the dribble. Steps.
All right, Bernie, let's move on. More Cleveland Cavaliers talk.
More Cleveland talk.
The greatest team in all of NBA. Just kidding. So Bleacher Report this morning reported that several people in the Cavaliers organization, I don't think they said whether it was players or...
I think it said players.
Did it say players too?
Players. There was players and also some, you know...
Some of the staff there. They came out and several prominent players came out and said that they didn't think that Cleveland had what it takes to win the championship with what they currently have, which means that they were certainly going to be making a trade before the deadline. Mm-hmm. But then Cleveland's GM, correct, came out and said that they weren't going to be trading the Brooklyn pick.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think they're going to try and do?
See, like, I'm torn between this because I've been listening to some talk show hosts in the morning, Colin Cowherd, just a little bit, like maybe an hour ago, just talking about, like, if you have LeBron James or if you're Cleveland, you win now. Yeah. You kind of trade, you mortgage your future so you can win now. But I'm in the realm of you don't want to do that because you really don't know, and you've talked about it in just the last segment, that you really don't know what LeBron is thinking and that his free agency loom is really affecting the team.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, like you've been told, like we talked about, you know, the front office is saying, hey, we're not trading away this Brooklyn pick because we could get lucky and maybe it could be number one again like it was when we drafted Anthony Bennett. Although they drafted Anthony Bennett and it wasn't good, they have a chance to still get the number one pick.
Yeah, agreed.
So I just don't see any way possible that you could trade that pick at all. Maybe I don't know if they have their own pick. Maybe they don't because they've traded for a lot of players before. I don't know. I just think there's just no moves that I see that could happen without giving the Brooklyn pick away.
Yeah.
And I just don't think that the Cavaliers are willing to do that until they get a confirmation from LeBron that says, hey, I'm staying for the long haul. So I just don't think that any move is going to happen. And I think the players' concern.
Mm-hmm.
Is justified.
Yeah. So two things. First of all, I think it kind of bums me out that LeBron is doing this to Cleveland again.
Yeah.
Just for the mere fact that I love LeBron. Mm-hmm. Like he's, in my opinion, the best player I've gotten to watch in my time as a basketball fan since I was a young little kid. Mm-hmm. Certainly, it's LeBron James, and for that fact, like. He seems like such a decent guy, like in every aspect of himself, like on the court, off the court. It just seems like he tries to do the best thing in every situation.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that we find ourselves in this situation yet again with him, kind of bugs me because it doesn't need to be this way. Obviously, he could either say I'm certainly going to leave, or you know I'm waiting till the end of the season. Even if he just said. I'm not sure I'm going to stay.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. If he came out and just said that, he hasn't even given us that much information. So just nobody knows where he's at. So with that being the case, it puts the whole Cleveland organization and all the players on the team in a bad spot. And I think that 15 years into his career, it's probably starting to make people a little bit, like it's getting people annoyed on the team, right. I would assume. Because like I said earlier, it's just like, it is certainly going to affect, and it is affecting the team and how they play right now and for the long haul of this season, especially as free agency and offseason gets even closer. It's going to become even more of a conversation that's going to distract the team. Secondly, I have a question for you.
All right.
Go ahead. That they would do this. It's just a question. Can they trade Isaiah Thomas?
I think they have to wait 60 days from when they traded him. So I think maybe they're close to it now.
Would it come up before the deadline?
I think so, yeah.
Because if that's the case, honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if they put him on the block or used him as a piece. I just wouldn't be surprised.
But I just don't know what you would get for him. I mean, like, he's a good player. I'm not doubting his ability to play the game. I'm just thinking, like, what logistically could someone get for Isaiah Thomas based on the fact that, hey, he's had a really bad hip surgery?
Yeah.
What could we get for him? I just don't know what team is willing to give up any like really big pieces. Like maybe you could give up IT for Lou Will and DeAndre Jordan if that contract matches up, which I don't think it does. I think you might have to trade Tristan Thompson along with that.
Interesting.
I mean, maybe you could do that, but I think that no team is going to trade with the Cavaliers unless that pick is involved.
Yeah.
Unless it's like some, you know, some run-of-the-mill players.
I'm just thinking as far as this Isaiah Thomas experiment is concerned, if they don't see anything from him as far as improvement by the time the deadline is like we're on it, which we're very close already, I really think he's going to come into some conversations.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't be surprised if when they do make the move, he's like the big piece that goes for them to get something.
Yeah.
And I don't think it... I think it's going to surprise people the value they get in return for him, like the general public, because 60 days ago they traded him for Kyrie Irving, you know?
Yeah.
They're not going to get Kyrie Irving value back. So when it comes down to like how that trade panned out for them, it's going to be one of the most colossal failures ever in trade history, really. And it's a bummer because Isaiah Thomas, if he was who he was last season, I still would have thought that this trade worked out in both teams' favors, but now it's just hard to think that way. But yeah, I do think they're going to trade for somebody big, whether it's Lou Williams, which I don't think he solves a lot of their problems. Like they need defense, and that's not Lou Will at all. If they trade for Lou Will, you know what they're going for, which is they're gonna just simply go to outscore the Warriors. That's their goal. But there's just no way that they can do that.
Yeah, just doing the trade machine right now, I think this trade would not work. I think they need a mill more.
Cavaliers need to give up more.
Yeah, they need to give up at least I think another player. But I don't think you could. I still don't think you could do this trade just based on the mere fact that, I think the Clippers said that they will not trade DeAndre Jordan unless they get a first round pick. So, it's going to be really hard to even try and comprehend doing this trade, even if you're just one player or 1 mil short.
I honestly wouldn't be surprised if the Cavaliers came up with this idea, like if they could get DeAndre Jordan and Lou Williams. I wouldn't be surprised if they were willing to actually give up the Brooklyn pick. I think that they're playing hardball with the pick, and if it comes down to throwing the season away or getting rid of it, they're going to get rid of the pick. Like, it's just 100%.
Yeah, it just sucks.
Because Brooklyn's not that bad. They're really not that bad.
No, they're going to be like, they're still going to be a lottery team, but they're not going to be, you know, in the bottom tier where the Hawks and the Magic are right now, I believe.
It'll be like the 10th or 11th pick, honestly.
Yeah.
Which, when it comes down to that, if you're getting the 10th pick, which would be like Miles Bridges or something like that, or you're getting DeAndre Jordan and Lou Williams, and you have a better chance to win right now, I think the Cavaliers are taking that.
Yeah. It's just hard, and just looking back at it, you know, just looking at all the stuff, even from last week when they played the Raptors, you know, Tyronn Lue said that players who have agendas, we need to get rid of them.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's been talks about players having their own personal agendas, you know, trying to maneuver it so it's basically they're in a good position. So if, like, LeBron leaves, they're in a position to shine and maybe get a bigger deal somewhere else.
Yeah.
Or just whatever agenda they have, Tyronn Lue thinks that that's going to be the case. And since Isaiah Thomas has come back, the person that I've been really disappointed in, because now he's basically back to the third option again, is Kevin Love.
I agree with you. I still think he's played better this year than he had for the 2 years prior.
Yeah.
And I know that I got some people angry with our DeMarcus Cousins trade video. I still think he's their best trade piece. Honestly, other than the pick. Clearly the pick is their best trade piece. Yeah. But I think Kevin Love is their best trade piece.
Because
his contract is pretty high, but it's not astronomically bad. He's still very productive. He's averaging a double-double in the high teens of points. I think he's at like 19.5 or something like that, points per game, and 12 rebounds or something like that. they could get some serious value from him if they included him in a piece. Like, let's say, and this is, I'm just throwing this out there. There's no way this would work just on the surface. They'd have to do some more finagling. But if they did Kevin Love, the pick, and Isaiah Thomas, right?
Okay.
You could do something where you get a superstar player for that amount of value. Mm-hmm. And if the Cavaliers did want a superstar piece in return, that's, I think it's hard to debate that that's their best option. But it's just hard to work those contracts and Isaiah Thomas, like, his health into it.
Yeah.
It's all about finding the right suitor. So, like, whether it's DeMarcus Cousins or not, I don't know. But I think he's probably the best option as far as superstars trading is concerned. They need to do something, though. And at least they admit they need to do something. But I think the last thing on this one, the Tyronn Lue agenda comment, I think is interesting because their best player and basically the co-coach of the team, LeBron James,
yeah, the co-coach,
has the most agendas of any player in the league.
Yeah.
So he's obviously making a comment towards LeBron, I think. And if he's not, then
I think it goes down to two players, Isaiah and LeBron, because Isaiah is playing for that contract. So if he, you know, if he doesn't play well this year, he's definitely not getting the max deal.
Yeah, I agree.
So let us know down below. What do you guys think the Cavs should do in this situation? Would you give up that Brooklyn pick? Would you not? And also, would you agree with Pete? Do you guys think that trading Kevin Love, Isaiah Thomas, and a first round pick will get you a superstar? Just let us know down below.
Or just who they should trade for. Let us know your thoughts on this Cavaliers discussion. Because honestly, I don't think there's anything they can do to win the championship. So
no.
Even getting DeMarcus Cousins, they would have a lot of issues. But that's besides the point.